Previously on Dream Team.
That makes him the new owner, doesn't it?
Wicked.
You've got my ticket, so you must have stolen it.
We both know you sold them to me.
That's a lie.
Look, you're the only liar here, mate.
Saturday morning.
The England player.
Dead tickets out.
What do you want, money?
Ryan Naismith came round here Saturday morning to pay Tony the money back he owed him for gambling debts. 50 grand. It's all there.
No, right, right. All this time you've been living in my yard, yeah? What do you mean trying to prove the balls are lying about me? And you've been on their side all along. What's that all about? Less conversation, a little more action, please. All this aggravation, satisfaction in me. A little more fight, a little less fun. A little less fight, a little more spark. Close your mouth and open up your heart and maybe satisfy me.
I'm here outside the luxury apartments that line Harchester Canal because I'm about to get up close and personal with one of football's brightest young stars. Clyde Connolly, 18 years old and already a legend at Harchester United, a club he believes is his. A natural from day one with a football, Clyde helped Ilmsford Celtic to three county championships with a goal average of just under four a game, before being signed, aged 11, by Harchester United Youth Academy. Breaking into the first team 7 years later, Clyde then became an instant hero by scoring the goal that kept Harchester in the Premiership. And now he's set to go even further. You look every bit the chairman, Clyde. Confident of winning?
Well, I knew when I was 5 years old I was going to be a Premiership footballer, and now I know that I own the club. See, it doesn't even matter that I haven't found the ticket out, because at the end of the day, you know, I'm the rightful owner, and I think everyone can see that. But like all Premiership footballers, even I have to go to training. Why don't you hop in?
That's some motor.
It's just my look to get the YTS, lad, isn't it? Look, all I'm saying is, mate, next time you're in the motor, take your shoes off, yeah? That's leather, not plastic, all right? Ah, our beautiful team coordinator, Miss Nicola Peggs. So, hello, Nicky.
What's going on?
It's off limits to the press, you know that, Clyde.
Oh, no, right, Mr. N, they're here for me, not Luke. Sky One's doing like a up close and personal.
Not without my permission, they're not.
The cameras aren't allowed into the club, it's in Luke's contract.
Stuart, I don't think you understand the nature of this publicity. I've got a claim to consider.
This claim stuff is not doing you any favours, Clyde. Your behaviour is becoming as bad as your football.
My football is the reason you're getting a Premiership salary this season.
I'm going to try and ignore that and simply remind you that that goal was last season. How many goals have you scored this season, eh?
Well, that's because you favour Luke and your precious Ryan.
You know you've not been playing well, Clyde, and I'm suggesting, for your own sake, forget TV profiles and owning this club and start getting your head down in training.
And I'm suggesting, for your own sake, that you start to show me some respect.
Go and get changed.
I don't care. She helped us out with the police, and I was grateful, but she had no right to take the money.
It wasn't ours.
50 grand? Gone? Oh, a few clothes and a pair of earrings. Just think what we could have...
You've got some cheek wearing that gear, lad.
Look, Kaz.
What a waste.
Our money.
And that's it? You're just going to cut it out?
How much does our lawyer cost? If we lose this claim, I really will have to sell the business. Do you think Donna will be around to help out then?
Yeah, but Dad, if it wasn't for her, prison.
She only done it out of greed. Now, those 40 grand earrings destroyed my gratitude. As far as I'm concerned, she's lucky to be under this roof.
Thanks a lot, Stuart. We've planned an hour show around Connolly, and now we haven't got time to research a new celebrity.
I need Clyde to concentrate on his football at the moment. I'm sorry. But
There might be someone else I can interest you in, though.
Me?
Of course. You're off to the England camp tonight with Luke. Your first game for your country. Now that's what I call a story.
I just don't think it's a good idea, Dad.
Why not?
Well, what about Clyde? He'll be gutted.
Don't worry about Clyde. He's got more important things to think about.
It is beautiful.
Come on, she, Marcel, she. Have some respect. Right, lads. I want you to meet Berlinetta.
See, this is actually the first Ferrari ever to be made entirely out of aluminium. Did you know that? She will go from a standing position to 62 miles per hour in, wait for it, 4.5 seconds.
Sorry. She got a top speed of 183. That's 183 miles per hour. And a 400 brake horsepower engine.
Lads, you are standing in the presence of greatness here.
How much?
See, Pete, Peter Mac, price don't come into it. You can either afford it or you can't.
What the hell is this? Clyde, man. I mean, there's a difference between being cool and uncool, bro.
And you just crushed it, mate.
Boss? You ain't nobody's boss.
You're just jealous.
Ah!
So keep your mind off the motor, man. We're losing.
You don't get a lollipop for finishing first. Just chill out, Curtis, man.
Oh, if you two have got enough breath to speak, that means you're not working hard enough. Now, come on.
Hey, Gaffer. I thought you said they couldn't film my profile.
That's right, they can't. And they're not going to. They're here to film Ryan.
You what?
We thought his first cat might make a better story.
This is blatant favouritism, just because he's your son.
That's got nothing to do with it. The fact that his football has been good enough to get him in the England squad is what this is about.
This isn't fair.
Don't point your finger at me, Clyde. Just keep this closed.
Take its toll. This year, he's determined to stay clean and serene.
Hi, love. So you're getting your roots done?
Cancelled. Looking good, babe. Aren't I good to you? Where have you lot been?
Oh, just to the Grange to get some breakfast.
Dressed like that? You didn't look that smart at Grandad's funeral.
Actually, we've been the solicitors, Donna.
Oh, Tony.
The solicitors? You can't go without me. I've got the seat you need me.
Our lawyer didn't seem to think so.
You'd be in prison if it wasn't for me.
I'd be 50 grand richer if it wasn't for you.
I earned that money.
You did no such thing. That money is my ass. I swear I'll have them earrings off you.
Oh, what are you going to do? Break into a bank next? Bit more glamorous than murder, I suppose.
Donna?
You are well out of line, as ever. And we're sick of it. We need you like we need a hole in the bleeding head. In fact, I'd rather have a hole in the head.
You can't talk to me like that. Tell him, Kaz. Dean? What about the suit? Dean?
Looks like you're on your own. You know where the door is.
Ready. Hey, would you mind moving, please?
It's my flat.
And I'm your boss.
Not for long.
Don't embarrass yourself. Kirsty be here soon. Do you want to look like an idiot in front of her? Come on, let's go. Chop, chop. Move it.
Shouldn't have went without her, Dad. It was wrong.
That girl's got to face reality. She has no claim and we're better off without her.
Stop saying that. She saved our bacon with the police, didn't she?
Only to save herself. I'll say it again, son. Donna Gibb is a selfish little tart and you're a fool not to see it.
Right, I'm going. I know when I'm not wanted. I'm leaving.
Don't you dare.
Hope you're happy.
You see,
As soon as her claim's threatened, she's out that door. That's how much she loves you.
Until you settle your previous bill, you can't book a room.
I can still have a drink, can't I? Lager top.
£4, please.
That's me. I don't know how you get away with it, but make sure you don't get injured. Otherwise, I'll tell Sven your parents are Scottish next time you come back, all right?
Clyde should be here.
I don't really care, mate.
That's not the point. This is a team event. He should be here.
Your car's here, boys.
All right. Come back.
Cheers.
Have I told you now? Proud I am of you.
Yeah. About 100 times.
All right, everyone, this is it. They're off.
Oh, boys, have it!
There you are. Always in the last place that I'm look. Why don't you come home, Donna? Please, baby girl.
Oh, so it's baby girl now, is it? Didn't care so much earlier, did you?
I'm sorry, it's just that...
You let Tony insult me? A real man would never let his fiancé be bullied like that.
Still fiancé then, yeah?
Not as long as you're shacked up with that bully, I'm not.
What does that mean?
You want to marry me?
Of course I do.
Good, then let's do it tomorrow.
What?
We can catch a plane to Las Vegas to get married tomorrow. As long as you tell your dad where to stick it, for good.
What do you mean?
It's me or him, Dean. I mean it.
What the hell are you playing at?
I've always fancied you.
This isn't some ploy, is it? To ruin my claim.
As if. Just wanted some fun, that's all.
What about what's his name? Dean.
Hardly Clyde Connolly, is he?
Did you really always fancy me?
Do you want me to prove it?
Donnie! Come home with me. Now.
Come on, I'm freezing.
Don't worry, I'll warm you up. Don't embarrass yourself, mate.
I love you, baby girl. Please come home with me.
To what? You and your bully of a dad? You see that car? The kind of man owns that. Is the kind of man I need. Strong, fast, classy.
chat. The kind of man owns that is the kind of man I need. Strong. Fast. Classy. Come on, I'm freezing.
I'll warm you up.
Listening to Radio Harchester. Here's another hit coming at you.
Morning, Clyde.
Oh, what happened last night?
Do you need a reminder?
Where is my car? Where's my car? Where's my car?
Relax, you parked it downstairs.
Carry on then. It's overweight, it's just get another drink and watch me come undone. They're selling razor blades and mirrors in the street.
What's the matter? And after, we could pick up where we left off.
Good idea.
So, what am I supposed to do while the cat's away?
Come on, play, baby.
Aren't you forgetting something?
So animal, so need your love, so you are. I'm not scared of dying, I just don't want to. If I stop lying, I just disappoint you. I come undone.
Backing up with your arch enemy, Clyde. This new tactic.
Any comments?
How's your tackle? Did you score?
Nice one.
Give us a smile.
Smile, come on.
Need a push. Clyde, I call you a cab.
Taxi!
Go, Mr. Connolly.
Nice paint job.
Smile, come on.
Need a push.
It's all right, cuz. I know.
Oh, Dean, I'm sorry, love.
Clyde Connolly, of all people.
I know. Just don't go doing anything stupid, okay? I've had enough police round here lately.
It's not just a scratch, sir.
And you've got no number plates.
Not the boss plates, too.
Breathe into this, please, sir.
I'm arresting you for drink driving.
Listen, lads, can we come to some sort of agreement?
Listen up, please. Okay, let's run through a couple of ideas. Should Luke and Ryan pick up Knox while they're away? Curtis, you're starting up front on your own. Supported by Marcel and Bruce. Bruce, I want you to push right up, okay? Tuck yourself right in the middle. Don't let them...
Oh, my God. It's a bit tangled. Please.
addiction. I know. Arrested. She's driving. She'll take it. This is a taxi. Come in, mate.
Is this going to cover it? Sorry about this.
Sorry.
Get yourself changed and back out here in 5 minutes. You're training with the reserves today.
Come on.
Now! Make him suffer, Andy. Where was I? I didn't tell you to stop. 20 more, Clyde.
20 more, Clyde.
And 20 more.
Why are you being such an idiot?
I don't need this, Curtis.
You don't need it? But that's cool, man. Because the way you're acting, man, we don't need you either.
Stuart's victimizing me.
Now he ain't kid. He's just angry. And so am I.
You're angry.
You're damn right. How do you think it makes me feel when somebody of your talent is just throwing it away like this? You know, some people have to work hard to be just as good as you. You don't know what you're missing. You don't know how lucky you are.
I know, he doesn't look good. Don't worry, I'll make sure he learns his lesson. Thank you for your concern, Mr.
Gaffer.
I've just had our MP on the phone, and before him, the mayor of Harchester. They're angry.
Oh, I don't see what they've got to do with...
You're a footballer. You represent the city. Kids look up to you. Don't you dare smile. You don't deserve one iota of their respect. You're a disgrace.
Boss.
The press is saying that you crashed that car in a drink driving incident.
No, I never crashed it. It was a...
Complete miracle, judging by the state of you this morning. Well, luckily, you won't need a car tonight. You'll be travelling by minibus. You're playing for the reserves at Orient.
No, Gaff, please. Not the reserves.
You will play for the reserves tonight, and the next week, and the next, until you learn how to behave. Bus leaves at 2.
Me and the reserves, can you believe that? Tell you, I'm a victim of Stuart Naismith's jealousy.
Someone with your talent, they should treat you with respect.
I know.
I mean, you own the place, for God's sake.
Yeah, about that. Hello? You what? You've just made the biggest mistake of your career, pal.
Who was that?
It's the police. You've been part of my car.
Why?
It's been smashed up, and I know exactly why.
Do you even remember what the morning looks like? You used to always be up at 7 and down the yard by 8.
Why get up if you don't have to?
Yeah, love, what are you looking for? I'll get it.
No, I'm just... Skeeting little tart.
She's just angry. You know, Donna, this is what she does. Don't go overboard, Tony.
Do you know how serious this is? If she tells Clyde about the tout, we're finished.
Oh, and there was me thinking you were worried about your son.
I want to talk some sense into it.
No, Tony. Not after yesterday. I'll go.
My problem is, I always go off things a bit too quick. I'd give it to you, but it's probably been the small side.
Oh, cut the crap, Don, and just come home and take them back.
I am not going back there to live with a murderer and his accomplices.
If we are, then so are you. You gave us the alibi.
Exactly, so why are you letting him push me out?
You're pushing yourself out. You should never have spent all that money, and he had every right to have a go at you. Oh, this isn't about you and Tony. This is about you playing games with all our futures. You tell Clyde about that tout.
Oh, the touts.
Yeah, if you tell him, then don't come running to me when he dumps you.
Dumps me? I don't think so.
Do you think he's going to be bothered with some scouse tart when he gets his club?
My own sister calling me a tart. How dare you?
No, how dare you? Dean's at home crying his eyes out. If you blab about that tout, then you mean nothing to me. And you'll be nothing to Dean or Clyde. You'll be on your own and you'll deserve it.
Where's Dean?
Hey, get out of my house.
No! He's killed my car. He's in it big time.
You've got no proof our Dean's done anything.
Get up, scum!
There's a proof.
Touch my boy!
Oh, assault as well.
Yeah, I'm going to the police.
Dad, you're making it worse.
You really think that they're going to hold you a football club? Should have put a pair of thieving bikies.
I'd watch where you're spreading your accusations if I was you, son. But you're not going to be the boss and not...
Oh, I am. Yeah. And you know your girlfriend, Dean? Yeah, the one who's in my bed right now. Yeah. She's going to help me.
Not mine.
What happened? My poor baby.
Donna, I need to know how you got them tickets.
Do we have to go into this now? I could be making you feel better. I know you're not going to believe me, but I don't know anything.
You're right, I don't.
It's the truth. Tony gave me my ticket outside the ground and we just walked in.
Lie.
It's not a lie. As if I'd have taken any notice where they got the tickets from. I didn't even want to be there. I hate football. Quite like footballers, though.
You never even asked them how they got the tickets.
Of course I did. Tony just told me to keep my trap shut. How do you think it feels to have your family shut you out like that, Clyde? It was horrible. You don't know how they bullied me. It's been hell. Lucky I've got you. If you still want me.
Ready and get yourself down here.
Yeah. I'll be down there.
Skating on thin ice as it is.
Ready, fancy a trip to London?
I suppose a trip to Harrods is on the cards.
Oh, sure. Mum, it's a personal mate of mine.
Anyway, Fletch was the worst, man. Passing tuna before every game or he wouldn't play.
Didn't you invent score?
That was a long time ago, man.
Oh, what? You're being a goody-goody because you got Grace now?
You're seeing Grace?
She's fine. But you went weeks without cleaning your boxes because of one clean sheet.
Oh, blimey, I'd rather lose.
Hey, it's going to take more than lucky boxes to sort you out, mate.
Your mum, is she still sewing your name into your shorts, Clyde?
Chris, why are you even here?
Practice, bro. Match is a match. Be good for these guys as well.
Yeah, but talking to him as well.
What is it with this guy, man? Absolute prat. Come on.
I made it clear to her, Tony. If she blabs, then he's probably going to dump her and then she'll end up with nothing. She's not a fool.
I suppose not. At least we finally got shut of her. When Dean gets the club, she won't get a penny.
Where is Dean?
Still sulking about Connolly, probably.
Oh, he's got to eat. Dean!
All of the guns were loaded and one up. An armed robber gets an extra...
Time to get up, Helen.
He's not there.
And time to explain.
What?
He's gone.
Oh, God.
You're the boss, baby! You're the boss!
It's a team game.
My Clyde's the best on the team.
Hey, well done, Gino! Good ball!
I can't get rid of you. 'Cause everywhere I go, you fail.
places. I want to banish you from whence you came. But you're part of me now, and I've only got myself to blame.
You're amazing out there.
Next call's for you, baby.
Clyde, another performance like the first half and you're off.
What do I need to do? Score six.
Kino, keep pushing up. You're doing well. You just got to get in the space.
Okay. Yeah, he can get in all the space he wants. He still ain't going to score. Look, that's right. Get the ball to me, to my feet, my head, whatever. I'll keep knocking him in.
Supporting the reserves.
I'm just here to support my Clyde. That stupid manager of his made him play with that lot. Imagine doing that to someone with Clyde's talent. Go on, darling!
Well, our boys, just keep it tight now.
John, you won't believe who I've just seen at Archester reserve match. Donna Gibb.
Off you come, son.
What are you doing, you idiot? I've just got an hat trick.
Huh? Listen, I've had enough of your attitude, man. Just get off this pitch.
You don't even fit to clean my boots. Ants, what are you doing? Ants, what are you doing? Just got an hat trick there.
What do they know about football anyway?
So, the reserves now then, Clyde.
You put anything about that and I'll sue.
So you're not too happy with Stuart Naismith's decision, then?
I shall tell you what I think of Stuart Naismith. You like that? You like that, do you?
Plenty more where that came from. Thank you.
I thought we went to London.
So did I. Oh, I still gotta go to training. Oh, no.
Chips et poisson.
Non, je voudrais des frites et des poissons.
Lads.
What's happening to you, man?
Nothing.
Is that what you think of this football club?
So leave us, Joe. I've never seen him this angry. You better have a damn excuse.
What for, black eye?
I think it's another part of your anatomy he's concerned about.
Morning, Gaffer.
What do you think of me? Is it Clyde?
You want to say something to me? You got the guts?
To my face? Come on, Clyde. How about we forget that I'm your boss for 5 minutes, eh? Back inside.
Gaff, just take it easy.
Thank you, Curtis. How dare you come into this club drunk? Look at the state of you. It's not just me you've humiliated. It's the team, those players in there, everyone at this club. And worst of all, it's the fans. You think they want an idiot like you in the squad, let alone in charge of their football club? I'm holding a press conference this evening in which you are going to stand in front of the cameras and apologize to everyone for your appalling behavior, and I mean everything. The drinking, the arrest, the reserve game, the newspaper, all of it. Understand? Good. And there's one more thing you're going to do, Clyde.
You are gonna dump that girl, Donna, right now, because if ever I've seen a bad influence, she's it. And if you fail to do either of these things, you will be suspended from this club. Do I make myself clear? Now get out of here. You're in no state to train.
Okay, thanks. Give us a ring if you get in touch, yeah?
Looked everywhere, love. Nothing.
I've called everyone we know in Liverpool. No one saw him.
What about the hospitals?
No. But that's a good thing, isn't it? What are we going to do?
I'm going to see Donna.
Donna?
We've got to get him back, Kaz, and like it or not, she's our best chance.
Oh, don't you think she's hurt him enough already?
Who is it?
Donna.
What do you want?
Done all right for yourself here, haven't you?
Tony.
Dean's gone. I've looked everywhere for him. I want you to get him back for me.
You want me to help you? Oh, I get it. Without Dean, you've got no claim.
Just want me son back.
Money's all you want. Why should I help you? I'm with Clyde now.
You tell Clyde about that tout, Donna. And I'll...
You'll what? You'll lay a finger on me, Tony. I bet you still think about that night, don't you? Or is your memory fading in your old age?
Shut up.
Oh, don't worry. We swore we wouldn't tell. And I haven't. Not yet, anyway.
Bitch.
Just how you like me. It's funny. One slip of my tongue and your wife, your son, and your precious football club will all be gone forever.
Baby, I'll shut you up myself then!
What's going off here?
He was threatening me.
Yeah, police, please.
Don't bother. I'm leaving.
Oh, thank God, I was so scared.
Why is there always trouble around you, eh?
A little reward for my hearing?
No, Donna.
What's up, baby?
I think I've gone a bit too far. Stuart's threatened to suspend me.
What? You can't do that. You're a legend. You're Clyde Connolly, for God's sake.
Yeah, well, Clyde Connolly's got to give a press conference tonight to apologise to Stuart and the team. Just about the whole flipping city. Everybody hates me.
You apologise. Clyde, you own that club. In a couple of months, you can sack Naismith and anyone else who gives you grief.
I don't own anything. There's about 15 people between me and that boardroom.
I might be able to help you with that. There was a tout, Clyde. We bought the tickets off a tout.
You said that...
Well, I wasn't just going to tell you.
You little beauty. I've won. That's it. 30 million smackaroonies. All mine. That Matt Webster is a mere formality. I'm a multi-millionaire!
Go on.
No need for apologies then.
Apologies, smologies. Ryan Naismith's dad, Stuart, can kiss my arse right before a firing.
Not quite yet. I mean, I still have to testify publicly.
It's not a problem. You can do it tonight before the press conference.
No way.
Why not?
Well, once I testify, my claim's dead in the water. I've got nothing.
So I'll look after you.
How do I know that for sure? I mean, you could just dump me.
As if, baby.
Sorry, Clyde. I need to have concrete assurance of that.
Well, what can I do?
What the? Where have you been? I've been all over looking for you. Karen's been on the phone all night.
Sorry. I'm missing her, Dad.
Well, get her back then, son.
From Clyde Connolly. She'll never come back.
Of course she will. She only left because you're too soft with her.
She left because you treated her like dirt.
I did not. I treated her fair and square.
Fair and square. Come on, Dad. You hate her. You've always hated her.
I was trying to protect you, you idiot. Stop her walking all over you, taking what's ours. She had no right to do that. That claim belongs to us.
The claim? Did I just hear you right?
I meant Donna's after it. Your money.
No. Donna was right. You're just after my money.
Talk so soft, Dino.
And she's right about you being a bully too. All you do is shout at me and make me lie and I hate it. You don't care about me at all. Oh my God, I can't believe I didn't see it sooner.
Come on, son.
Forget it. Dad. And you can kiss your rich dreams goodbye. I'm gonna get Donna back. And I'm gonna marry you. And from now on, Tony. It's just me and her. No one else. Not you. And not Karen. No one!
Dean, get back here! Now!
I've tried everywhere. His mobile phone switched off. There's no one answering at the flat.
No Clyde yet, Stuart.
He won't be long.
Sure, I hear the buses are terrible round here.
What end will Clyde be communicating with today, Stuart?
Donnie! You in there? Donnie? I know you don't want to speak to me, but... Look, there's just something I want to say to you. I'm going to tell you it anyway. Maybe he's in there. With you. Maybe you both think this is funny or something. I don't care. Look, Donna, I've been doing some thinking. And you're right about me, Dad. You're always right, baby girl. I'm sorry. I'm just sorry. I love you, Donna. And I want you to be my Mrs. Boyle. More than anything else in the world. Right now, just like you said, just me and you, there'll be no one else but me, Dad, no one. Because all I need is you. Just me and you, Don. Because I love you. I just love you.
My very last dime. And if I wind up broke, then I'll always remember that I had a swinging time. Viva Las Vegas. Do you, hound dog, take this little lady to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
And you, little lady?
I do.
I now pronounce you man and wife. Uh-huh.
Gentlemen, ladies, I have an announcement to make. Clyde Connolly is suspended from this club with immediate effect.
Coming soon on Dream Team.
What are you looking at?
My future.
Joyce, this is Nikki.
Hi. My fiance.
What the hell is going on?
You really have me thinking I could be a football agent? You are despicable.
Nikki. Look, I let the guy stay in my house, man. He doesn't make him his babysitter.
Wake up, Ryan! Oh, my God! Ryan! Ryan!
Fire!